Hi, my name is Rebecca Bilo, and this is my daughter, Adri Bilo, and we both have Fabry disease.
I was diagnosed with Fabry disease a little before my 30th birthday, and I feel like I have a beautiful life full of wonderful things, and I try really hard to be positive and to be a happy person, but there are a few things that I would love to take out of my life, and one of them would definitely be having Fabry disease, but I think I would just love for people to know what it is.
It kind of takes over some part of my life, and depends on like what kind of day I'm having.
My first symptom was when I was 10, and I had horrible stomach pains, but I didn't get diagnosed until 2011.
I was diagnosed with Fabry when I was 30 years old. After a kidney transplant, we discovered that all the problems with the kidneys were caused by Fabry disease.
I'm 39 years old. I have Fabry. I got diagnosed when I was 32 years old. I'm receiving treatment.
I've been symptomatic with my disease since I've been around 11, 12 years old, and I wasn't diagnosed until I was 27.
Fabry disease is a new discovery in my family. After a cousin passed away, it was identified. I was 51 when I was first diagnosed, as are 11 other of my family members.
I was diagnosed with Fabry when I was 25. I've been receiving treatment for it for the past 6 years. My son is 9, has been receiving treatment for it since he was 7. And my mom has been receiving treatment for it for about 3 years.
It's not something that is necessarily easy to take or easy to understand when you first get the diagnosis.
My younger brother Ken died from kidney failure caused by Fabry disease when he was only 37 years old.
My two younger brothers, one that's 3 years younger than me, had kidney failure before I did. And so no one knew at that point why his kidneys failed, but when I hit 50, they did a diagnosis for me and found that I had Fabry disease. Then they went back and tested his kidneys biopsy and found that he did have Fabry disease.
There's times that, as a mother of four, I hurt too much to do things that my kids want to do, which makes me feel really guilty. And there's times that I worry about making sure that I am healthy enough to be able to help them when they get older, be moms and dads and take care of my grandbabies.
Four of my family members died from Fabry disease, all under the age of 50 years old.
Due to Fabry, I was unable to meet my grandfather, who passed away at the age of 42.
I would love to be able to plan to have another baby and not worry about whether or not my son or daughter will have this is the same genetic disease that I have and how that's going to affect their quality of life. So Fabry disease is a hard thing.
I've been diagnosed with congestive heart failure at the age of 42, and I had my first TIA 6 years ago, and I'm 42 now.
My dog can also pick up on when I have a pain crisis, and he comes over to me and he lays down next to me until I take medication and it passes. But he has always picked up on that on his own, and I've had him for 7 years.
I had a defibrillator and a pacemaker installed at 51. I had a heart attack at 52 and had a stent placed, and I have Fabry disease.
And Adri here already has trouble when it's hot. She can't play, she doesn't sweat, so she can't play very hard, and she has to take breaks. And so there's times that she can't play with the little kids because she's too hot and she can't cool herself down.
My parents took me to like all the specialists and, you know, trying to figure out because of my symptoms, what was wrong. And this, all they could ever say was I was just different. You know, they had no clue.
I myself have a ton of joint pain and headaches. I have kidney disease from Fabry disease. My son is constantly in and out of doctor's appointments. He misses school.
I missed a lot of school for like treatments, and I can't really do a lot of the activities that all the rest of my friends do.
Hi, my name is Taylor Hoffman, and I have Fabry disease.
I was originally diagnosed with Fabry's when I was 28 or so, and at that time they didn't really know a whole lot about it. So consequently, I didn't really do anything about it, and I guess how many years? 30 years later, it's kind of caught up with me now, and I've got heart issues, and in the middle of all that, I had a stroke. So it's kind of caught up with me.
Fabry disease, with its many devastating symptoms, is hiding in thousands of families all over the world. The clues that would help physicians and families recognize Fabry disease are often overlooked. Fabry disease is often undiagnosed or misdiagnosed as many other conditions. When Fabry disease is diagnosed, it's often diagnosed too late after irreversible organ damage occurs. With treatment available, children should not have to live a poor quality of life. And adults should not have to die prematurely because of Fabry disease. Together, we can beat this disease. We need your help to provide physician, family, and public education to increase early recognition and diagnosis of Fabry disease, and to help people with Fabry disease better understand and manage their disease. Please make a tax-deductible, charitable contribution to the National Fabry Disease Foundation today. Thank you on behalf of so many people whose lives will forever be changed for the better because of your generosity.